installing software safely and with minimal impact. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for AskLeo.com. One of the really common questions or scenarios that I hear about are people that have machines that are slow or pokey. They weren't always, but they've been slowing down over time. And also, they've become somewhat unstable. Now, granted, in recent years, things have gotten better, but it's still an issue. And the issue is simply that often the machines are running too much software, or they're running software that doesn't need to run, to be honest. What it really boils down to is it's important to understand how to install software, how to install it safely, and whether or not to install it at all. Let's go through some of the thoughts that should go into any kind of installation before you run that setup program. Number one, you know what? Avoid it if you can. By that I mean, sometimes we install software a little too easily. That's the latest exciting thing, and we want to give it a try, and we install it on our machine, and there are side effects, and we don't uninstall later, and eventually enough of that stuff collects so that it ends up impacting our system's performance. So the best software, the software that will not impact your performance, is the software you never install. So think twice before installing anything to make sure it's something you really want to install. Now, testing things, I totally understand. Sometimes you don't know if you want a particular piece of software until you've had some experience with it, until you've tried it out. If you can, I know this doesn't work for everybody, but if you can, install it on a different machine. Install it on an older machine, or install it on your second machine, or whatever. Basically, designate which machine is the most important to you. Like, I'm staring at my desktop machine right now. It's the most important machine I have. And don't install software on that as your first knee-jerk reaction. Use a separate machine. That way, if something goes wrong, or if it does end up adversely impacting you, then you haven't impacted your most important piece of hardware. If you decide you want it, then absolutely. Then you can make a much more informed decision that, yep, this software is going to be useful. I'm going to use it for a long time. Let's install it on my main machine and we'll be great. Another scenario, and this is a slightly more advanced one, and ultimately is what I end up doing in a lot of cases, is to have a virtual machine available. In other words, you only have your one computer. For risky software, if you understand what a virtual machine is and you have the ability to set one up, virtual machines are great for testing things because you can wipe out the virtual machine and start over very, very easily. Or you can take checkpoints of the virtual machine, which basically boil down to backup image of the virtual machine prior to installing the software so that you can limit your exposure to it and still be able to make that same better informed decision. When you are installing software, pay very careful attention to everything that the setup program asks you about. In particular, always choose custom. Sometimes it's referred to as advanced, or sometimes there's some other wording, but the bottom line is if there is a link or a checkbox or some other gateway to more advanced settings, then take that. The problem is that the default settings, they might be okay, but they might not. More often than not, the default settings are the correct settings for the application, for their intent, for what they think they want to do on your machine, not necessarily what you want to do on your machine. That's really important because, again, not all software is like this. Sometimes the default option is exactly correct, but you don't know that until you've gone through the advanced option to see that there's nothing you want to change. On the other hand, very often you will find in the advanced options things that you don't want, you don't need. The worst case scenario is what we refer to as foistware. In other words, there'll be checkboxes on the advanced screen. Sometimes it's on the main screen, but on the advanced options that say, hey, while you're installing this, I've got this other thing that we think you'll like, and I'll install it for you automatically. If you never look at those options, if you don't pay attention to those options, you're going to get unrelated software that you don't want or need. It happens often, unfortunately, especially with a lot of free software, because it's how the free software actually makes money. They get some kind of a kickback or a fee for successfully installing this other software that they have nothing to do with on your machine. So pay very, very careful attention to all of the options that are made available as you install software. One of those options is sometimes starting with Windows. By that, the option is an option to automatically run the software when you boot your machine or when you sign into Windows yourself. For some applications, that's exactly correct. You want that. Great example is Dropbox. You want the Dropbox application to run automatically because it's going to do things automatically in the background that you want it to do all the time. On the other hand, there are other scenarios. For example, some Office suites. It used to be Microsoft Office. I don't think they do it anymore. I have heard that some of the OpenOffice or LibreOffice options do this. They will install a little utility that runs automatically whenever you start Windows that preloads their app into RAM. What that means is it slows down your start, but it makes it look like starting the application is much faster because it's already in RAM. You don't need that. You seriously don't need that. In fact, it's actually detrimental because unless that application with that option is the most important thing that you do and the thing that you always do every time you boot your machine, you're slowing yourself down for no useful reason. So make sure to understand whether or not those options are really required and turn off the ability or the feature to automatically start with Windows or start with login. There are various terminologies that you're pretty certain you don't need. You can always run them later. This isn't going to break anything. You can always run the application later and go back in and turn on that option if you decide you really do want it to start. But it's not something that you necessarily need. And if it's something you don't need, why have it? Now, of course, you can always go back to the Task Manager's startup tab and uncheck a few things that are starting automatically anyway. Some applications don't ask. They just assume you want whatever it is they install to run automatically. The startup tab on the Task Manager is where you're going to find most of that. Again, starting up with Windows, think twice. Some things you want, like your anti-malware tools, some things you don't, like applications that check for periodic updates and so forth. Those should be happening in the application and shouldn't require a separate utility running all the time in order to check for updates. If you're ever curious, take a look at the lower right-hand corner of your monitor, the taskbar notification area. Each one of those little icons represents something that's running. And often when you run something automatically at startup, that's where it appears. It throws another icon into the notification area. That's a good other way of auditing exactly what it is that's running on your machine that you might want to see if there's an option to turn off. So, in summary, very quickly, don't install software unless you know you need it. Testing software, if you can, do that on another machine or in a virtual machine if at all possible. Always choose custom or advanced to see all of the available options. Uncheck all of the options you don't want or need. Definitely uncheck options that are unrelated to the software you're installing. And then, of course, think twice before letting software automatically start with Windows or your sign-in. Hope that's helpful. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/6559. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.